which, transient global amnesia, TGA, transient global amnesia, which is losing your entire memory and ability to form new memory from time to time. So they thought he had a stroke, took him to a neurologist, said he didn't have a stroke, and he said the only different thing he had done was take Lipitor. And the doctor said, no, Lipitor statins don't do that. Within another few days, he said that, look, nothing's improving. So his wife decided to stop it. He stopped the statin drug. Within, I don't know, about a week, his memory came back, so he stayed off of it. A year later, he went back to his flight surgeon in NASA in Houston, and the doctor said, look, your cholesterol's too high. You need to go back on the statin. He said, look, doc, the last time I did that, I lost my memory. The doctor said, no, statins don't do that. So he went back on it. And again, within a week or so, his memory was lost. So he finally went off of it. He wrote a couple of books. One was, I got them here. One was Statin Drug Side Effects and the Misguided War on Cholesterol. And the other one was Lipitor, Thief of Memory. And you can get both of those at spacedoc.net, SPACE, DOC.NET. And he has written a lot of articles also. It's on his website, spacedoc.net. But that basically documents the fact that he had memory loss from taking Lipitor. For him, it was Lipitor, but all statin drugs can do that. Now, the main side effect of statin drugs come because it depletes CoQ10. So if you are choosing to take statin drugs, you need to take CoQ10. Ours is called Super Q Gel. You can get Q Gel at health food stores, and that'll prevent a bunch of side effects, not always memory loss. But later, after I had interviewed Dr. Gravlin, which again is on our website at 1-800-CHEMIST.com under Health Connection Radio, under tape broadcast. You can listen to it there. After I had interviewed him, ABC News had mentioned that people have problems with memory loss with statin drugs. So you get all that information on our website, 1-800-Health Connection Radio, undertake broadcast. Tomorrow we're going to talk about hormone imbalances in men and women. More information on our programs at Body Chemistry Associates, 34 years in the business of human nutritional biochemistry, 1-800-CHEMIST, 1-800-243-6478, 7 days a week here from 2 to 3 p.m. on WWNN. More information on our programs and Body Chemistry Associates, 1-800-CHEMIST, 1-800-243-6478, on the web, 1-800-CHEMIST.com. Jay Foster and Health Connection Radio, saying thanks for tuning in today. Enjoy the rest of the beautiful day. We'll be with you again tomorrow at 2.
The preceding sponsored program were strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Hi, this is Michael Blum. Join me on Mondays from 9 to 11 p.m. on WNN for the Michael Blum Show, where we talk about the things you don't want to talk about. We talk about sex, substance abuse, spirituality, and politics. Think, speak, and be heard. Join us on the Michael Blum Show.
Are you saving for college? 529 college savings plans are offered by states to provide easy and affordable ways to save. Saving in advance is a key part of preparing for higher education and avoiding high student loan debt. National studies show that students with savings are much more likely to attend and graduate from college than students with no savings. For more information on how you can get started, visit collegesavings.org.
Talk 1470, WWNN, Pompano Beach, Boca Raton, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Aging in the sun are the greatest sources of damage to the skin. Vitamin C applied as a serum may help improve the pigmentation, roughness, and fine lines of damaged skin. This improves firmness, tone, radiance, and texture. Vitamin C, a strong antioxidant, helps form collagen, which fills in the skin and lends to smoothness, helping your skin look younger and more beautiful. Invite Health, a respected leader in nutrition, offers a very pure, high-quality vitamin C toning serum that is free of the fragrances and parabens that can mimic the effects of estrogens in your body. Take advantage of this great offer from Invite. Call now to purchase one bottle of vitamin C toning serum for $19.95 and receive a free protective hand cream along with free shipping. That's a $59.85 value for just $19.95. This is a limited time offer. Contact Invite at 800-804-0973. Support the healthier skin safely with Invite's vitamin C toning serum. Call 800-804-0973. That's 800-804-0973. 0973. You can also visit an Invite Health location or visit InviteHealth.com.
Gallbladder problems, gingivitis, a bad back, indigestion, fatigue, low libido, not sleeping well, need to lose weight? Just some of the topics you'll hear about. Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Martin. Join me Sunday mornings at 10 on Talk 1470 WNN.
Let me ask you a question. When you think of the American Legion, what comes to mind? Is it the way we fight daily for our veterans to get them the benefits they've earned through their service?
I work hard every day to make sure that our veterans get the benefits they deserve. I am the American Legion.
For nearly 100 years, the American Legion has been our nation's leading advocate for veterans and their families.
I am the American Legion.
This is today's American Legion.
To learn more, visit legion.org.
Talk health. Talk wealth. Talk politics. Talk 1470 WNN.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
The information on this program is not intended to be a substitute for or a replacement for any professional medical advice or services. You should not use this information to diagnose or treat a health issue or concern without consulting your qualified healthcare provider. Coaching for Health always advises you to seek advice prior to starting any new treatment or regimen of any kind. Any actions and applications resulting from the recommendations on this program are at the listener's discretion. Welcome to Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker. Suzy is a certified health coach and has her practice base in Delray Beach, Florida. Listen here to find out how Coaching for Health can help you get and stay on the right path to your health and wellness. Spend an hour learning about current topics on all things health and how you can apply them in your life every day. Now, here's Coaching for Health with our host, Suzy Bricker.
Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this show today. It's January 27th already, the last Wednesday of January 2016. I am Suzy Bricker. Yes, I am. I am your certified resident health coach. This is Coaching for Health on WWNN Radio, 1470 AM. You can get us on the iHeartRadio app, which is almost like your one-stop shop app. You can get us on iRadio Now, TuneIn apps on our very, very smart phones. Again, you can stream us live at WWNNradio.com, amp2.tv. You can get this show on YouTube, Coaching for Health, with Suzy Bricker YouTube or Coaching for Health YouTube. And I am so happy to say I have a new website up and running, www.coachingforhealth.net. Please go on my website and you'll get a lot of great information. You can contact me. So that's very exciting for me as well. And for all of you, thank you for tuning in. It's a pleasure to have you. I know I have to get the hair out of my little strands. It's my honor and my pleasure every week to bring you health and wellness from a health coaching perspective. I'm going to talk about what health coaching is in a couple of minutes and what the parameters and of what I do as a health coach and things I do in my practice, which is very, very unique. But what I try to do every week is bring you cutting edge in your face, on your mind and body health and wellness that affects every part of you integratively, including our wallets. I cover nutrition, supplements, exercise physiology, mind-body health integration, even pet health, and much more. So I'm hoping that every week that you tune in, you will gain some new insight about your own health and wellness and be proactive, because this is what this show is really all about. So let me just start today by giving you a little bit of information about what health coaching is. A lot of people ask me, well, what is a health coach? What do you do? What distinguishes you from other practitioners? And the people in the health and wellness industry, I thank everyone. We're all great, because it's our mission and it's my mission to really make a difference in this world and to help people get healthy and well and empower everybody to take charge of your own health and your own wellness and to really, really start to know who you are and how to move yourself through the ages, the life passages, the transitions, every stage of your life. So health coaching it's very unique. It's a booming profession in healthcare, and I've talked about this before. But what I do is a bit different, and I have positioned myself differently as a health coach because I believe in my own health and wellness, as I've learned how to do with metabolics and blood work and blood panels and nutrition and supplements and exercise physiology. So it's really an integrative bio-individual process. And the key to this, the key for me in my practice, and I believe for health coaches and healthcare and practitioners moving forward, and I did a story about bio-individual health last week, is that I don't plug you into a program. I construct the program for you. So in other words, what I do is totally individual to who you are and what your issues are, what your goals are, and we plan accordingly. So one of the real benefits, and there are so many to this health coaching profession and what I do, is that you get to know yourself in ways that you have never gotten to know yourself before. And if you don't know you, and I don't know me, then how is anybody else going to know you? And that is the real key to this program and to my own health and wellness, and I believe into your health and wellness. So let me just give you a brief history about health coaching. And I do have some notes, because as much knowledge as I believe I have, I don't know everything. Of course, who knows everything? But coaching has been around since the beginning of time. And health coaching certainly became mainstream in the 1990s. And it's really health and wellness and coaching has become so mainstream, because I think we realize now, as we're moving forward into this 21st century, that it's a one-on-one process, that we all need a mentor. We need somebody who believes in us. We need somebody who's interested in us. We need somebody who has knowledge to be able to give to us so that we can give it to ourselves. And that's what this coaching profession is all about. So in the next segment, I'm going to give you the phone number. And please call in our next segment. It's 865-1470. I'm going to open the phone lines in the next segment. You can join the conversation. You can ask me questions about health coaching. I'd really love to hear from you, any of you, my wonderful listeners. If you have hired a health coach, if you're interested in health coaching, if you've had the benefits from using a health coach, if any other questions you may have about what this fabulous profession of health coaching is. So again, I'm going to open the phone lines in our next segment, 1-888-565-1470. Join the conversation. So one of the things I want to talk about in respect to my coaching practice and what makes coaching for health so unique is my training, my philosophy, my own health and wellness journey, and the really hands-on mentoring process that goes on in this coaching program, this bio-individual, again, coaching program. So one of the things that's very important is how I go about doing things in my practice. I want to talk about primary foods and secondary foods. It's a unique approach to health and wellness. It's a unique approach to health coaching. And it is one of the techniques that I have learned in my fabulous education as a health coach. And yes, we are highly educated, certified professionals in healthcare. We have hands-on training. I am well-versed in over 100 nutritional theories that I can apply at any given stages of any given program with my clients, whether they be family, individual, or corporate clients. And that's one of the distinguishing factors in coaching for health with me. So when I talk about primary and secondary foods, this is really something unique. And I really want you to understand that this is an integrative process. So we can use our minds without our bodies, which can be very unfortunate in certain health conditions. But we can't really use our bodies and become healthy unless we have our minds going in the right direction. So when I speak about primary foods and secondary foods, primary foods really are, there's 12 aspects of life, the foundations of our life. And the primary foods in my practice are aspects of our foundation, such as joy, spirituality, home life, relationships, education, socialness, creativity, finances, physical activity. I believe I said education, career. So there's 12, and nutrition, which is certainly not last and not least. But there's 12 foundations that I build my life on and my practice on that are absolutely non-negotiable foundations. And I will use that word a lot as we go through this show in the weeks to come. The healthy foundations on how to build your health and wellness. So when I talk about these 12 foundations of life, this is the primary food. And one of the things that I do in my practice is I sit down with my clients and we talk about where my clients are in respect to these 12 really important foundations of their life. And depending on the areas where there's strengths, where there's weaknesses, where there's goals, where the goals have been met, where we have challenges, is how one of the tools that I use to move forward in establishing a secondary food foundation for my clients. So that's one of the aspects that distinguishes me and my practice in coaching for health from other health practitioners. And again, there are many, many, many fabulous practitioners, and we are all devoted, hopefully, to your health and wellness. But this is something that I've used in my own personal health and wellness, and this is something that as I get older, and yes, I am getting older, I am pushing a certain age away. 60 is the new 30. I'm not there yet, but I am proud every birthday that I spend, and you should be too, that I am getting better and I have gotten better as I've gotten older because of this health coaching and the health coaching profession and what I do. So when we come back after the on the other side of the break, I'm going to talk a little bit more about primary foods. We're going to talk about secondary foods, maybe get into the hot health topics for the week, and take your calls. See you on the other end.
Being the best takes time, talent, and determination. Getting the most of those things takes coaching. Think of the most successful athletes or performers. They've all got a stable of experts coaching them in every area of their lives. Don't we all wish we could get, let alone afford, that level of service? Well, you can, without sacrificing quality, by working with Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health. Suzy has extensive knowledge of healthcare strategies, including nutrition, supplements, and exercise physiology, combined with life and career coaching. The results are life-altering, immediate, and sustainable. To find out how you and your family can benefit from Coaching for Health, go to the website coachingforhealth.net or send Suzy an email at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. Don't forget to schedule your free consultation and be on your way to the healthy, happy life you deserve. Call 248-762-4961. Stress is dangerous. We live in a world where we are subjected to it each and every day. These stressors can wreak havoc on our health, cause disease, and affect our daily lives. Stress seems to create or worsen conditions like obesity, weight issues, high blood pressure, Alzheimer's, diabetes, depression, gastrointestinal problems, sleep disorders, well, the list goes on. It creates a whopping 80% of all visits to the doctor in this country. Enter adaptogens. Natural longevity adaptogens. Adaptogens are a unique, amazingly powerful group of ingredients that adapt their function according to your body's needs. They are the most effective, side-effect-free natural stress reduction solution on the planet. Better sleep, better stamina in all areas, improved circulation, and increased overall feelings of well-being are just some of the stunning benefits. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. That's ADAPT, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. Natural longevity adaptogens, the most powerful formula, period.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker, your resident certified health coach. It is Wednesday, January 27th again, another Wednesday, the last Wednesday of the month for 2016, January 2016. Boy, this month has gone by like a joke. It is this show is on every Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m., WWNN Radio, a wealth of health and wellness and finance information with so many great, great practitioners, and I am so honored and happy to be a part of this great family. Before the break, I was talking about coaching for health and health coaching and what I do as a health coach and primary food and secondary food, which is unique to my practice and unique to health coaching and certainly a great foundation for your health and wellness. I want to read a couple of passages to you about primary food to help you understand why it is so important for the foundation of our health and for this particular coaching program and for your bio-individual health and wellness. So let's talk about primary food a little bit more so that we really understand what it is. We consider nutrition, most of us consider nutrition as the primary source of health and wellness, but it really isn't. It's the secondary source of health and wellness. It's the secondary source of our energy. The primary source is primary food. And I mentioned before the break the 12 aspects, the 12 different areas of our foundation, which are, which our our primary foods. So think about it this way. Remember a time when you were deeply involved in an exciting project. You believed in what you were doing, and you felt confident, and you felt stimulated. Time seemed to stop. The outside world just faded away. You didn't need the eat that you didn't need or feel the need to eat. Somebody had to come and remind you. All right, well, that's okay. That's a good thing. But let's go more into primary foods. As children, we all lived on these primary foods. We were happy. We were carefree. We were just building our lives. So primary foods feed us, but they don't come on a plate. And that's really the most important thing. They don't come on the plate. The plate follows. This is really the plate that we want to build first. Elements such as a meaningful spiritual practice or meaningful spiritual lives, an inner career or an inspirational career, an inner force, a core, regular and enjoyable physical activity, and honest and open relationships and communication that feed your soul and feed your core and your hunger for living, for the living, all constitute primary food. The more primary food we receive, the more in line we become with this primary food, the less we depend on secondary foods. This is a whole new concept in nutrition, and I believe will really make a difference on our obesity rates in this country, which are through the roof. It's really innovative if you really think about it. So the opposite is also true. The more we fill ourselves with secondary foods and the more we put the cart before the horse, which is what we are guilty of in this society, the less we are able to receive the primary foods of life. Again, the mind can work without the body, but the body cannot work without the mind. It's all truly integrative, and it has to work in tandem. And that's what this is all about. Every spiritual tradition encourages people to fast during the year so that individuals have time to reduce secondary foods, allowing for a greater awareness of primary foods. I'm going to do a show in the very near future about fasting. I've had a lot of my clients ask me about fasting and juicing and cleansing and those types of things. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the healthy ways to do that, because that's really something that's mainstream in our society is fasting, juicing, and cleansing. So I'm going to talk to you about how to do that healthfully. But what I want you to do is to take the time to explore your primary foods as you journey through this program, whatever programs you're going to be going through. Hopefully it will be a health coaching program or a practitioner who is bio-individually geared for you. Take the time to do that part of your journey, and the secondary foods will come. So the secondary foods are the nutrition. The secondary foods are the supplements, should they be. The secondary foods are physical exercise, exercise physiology, mind-body integration. That's where the integrative process comes in. But the primary foods come first. So when I started my education process in 2009, and I really grasped that concept of primary food, and I really integrated all of those aspects of my life and built the healthy foundation, that's when my true health and wellness started to kick in. So I want you all to think about that. If you have questions, I opened up the phone lines, 1-888-565-1470. Join the conversation. If you have questions about health coaching, please call and ask. If you've used a health coach, I'm really interested to hear what your experiences are. If you're interested in using a health coach, of course, call. Let's answer your questions. And I'm open as the phone lines are open. So I look forward to hearing from all of you. All right, let's go into some of the hot health topics for the week. There was a very interesting little blurb, and I find this cutting edge kind of funny, actually, and I wanted to mention it, about high-rise living, which is linked to lower survival rates and cardiac arrest. Now, I know that a lot of us in a lot of cities across the country, especially New York, Chicago, even LA, live in high-rise buildings. And it's become a mainstay of our lives. But there was an interesting study, and it kind of makes sense, and it is what it is, but I just wanted to mention it because I thought it was kind of funny, that the higher the floor you live in, the lower your chances of surviving a cardiac arrest, according to a new study. Now, it's pretty obvious as to why that may be the case, but it's interesting. If I'm going to give you some of the statistics why it's interesting. Now, this was based more on a Canadian study. 7,842 responses to cardiac arrest called in private residences in and near Toronto. From 2007 to approximately last year, cases of trauma and those witnessed by 9/11 responders were excluded. When the cardiac arrest occurred below the third floor, 4.2% of the patients survived discharge from the hospital, compared to 2.6% of those on higher floors. So above the 16th floor, 0.9% survived, and above the 25th floor, where 30 people had cardiac arrests, some lived to leave the hospital. All right, so I don't know if the air is thinner up there, but I find this to be a little bit preposterous. But interesting, worth mentioning. So I don't know that there's really a point in this. I wanted to mention it because for all of those people who live in high rises, get to the gym, make sure that your health and wellness is on target, make sure that you have all your ducks in order, enjoy your views. But I think this is a bit of a preposterous study. And again, Coaching for Health brings to you cutting edge, in your face, health and wellness, and I think this is kind of a little bit preposterous. So it is what it is. All right, let's talk about yoga. For those of you who know me or have used my services, health coaching services, I am an avid yoga practitioner. I have been practicing Bikram yoga, which is the hot yoga, Bikram Chowdhury, God bless you, for over 25 years. It is a mainstay in my life. It is a staple of my health and wellness. It has saved my health and wellness physically, emotionally, and physiologically. And I encourage all of you, no matter who you are, how old you are, how healthy you are, how wealthy you are, to get into a yoga program. And there are so many incredible yoga programs, but it's just really, really something you need to incorporate in your health and wellness. So there was an article about 12 minutes of yoga for your bone health. Now, again, yoga is fabulous, and I am not a proponent in 12 steps and quick steps. I'm not a proponent of the 5 steps to easy this or the 10 steps to easy that. And I'm not really a proponent of 12 minutes for yoga and bone health. I believe that the practice and the class of and the motivation and the time involved in the practice is what's important. There are no quick fixes in this world, and I don't really believe in 12 minutes of yoga. But when we come back on the other side of this break, I'm going to talk to you about an interesting study about 12 minutes of yoga, and then we will also talk about peanut butter. So you peanut butter aficionados, hang in there, stay tuned.
Whether your business has 5 employees or 500, they need to work as a winning team. Your bottom line depends on it. Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health will work with you and your staff individually and collectively to build a customized plan that will work for your business. Suzy specializes in health and wellness programs that will improve employee productivity, reduce absenteeism, create a happier, healthier work-life environment, and increase staff loyalty and commitment to their careers and your company. All of which adds up to a greater return on your investment for you, lower healthcare costs, attracting highly qualified new employees, and promoting an atmosphere of financial success. Contact Suzy Bricker at Coaching for Health at 248-762-4961. That's 248-762-4961. And at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. For more information, go to her website, coachingforhealth.net. Find out today how to build and create the right health and wellness program for your business. Call 248-762-4961 or email susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. You've heard the saying, you are what you eat. Think about it. And for most of us, that's not a pretty picture. Compound that with the way our bodies metabolize and break down what we put into them, or not. Well, that's truly a recipe for disaster. Because we primarily consume a diet of processed foods, foods that have no or relatively no enzyme or nutritional content, we create disease all over the body. Heartburn, fatigue, inflammation, of course digestive issues, and a compromised immune system are just some of the issues we deal with daily as a result of this. Enter digestive enzymes. Natural longevity digestive enzymes. PhytoBioForte digestive enzymes and trace minerals. PhytoBioForte is the most potent plant-based digestive enzyme with trace minerals product available. Completely digested foods are the answer or solution to many health problems. And if you begin a daily routine of using PhytoBioForte, you may be amazed at what can happen. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adapt4health.com/WWNN radio. That's adapt4health.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adapt4health.com/WWNN radio. Natural longevity, PhytoBioForte. The choice is yours.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker, your resident certified health coach. Before the break, I was talking about yoga. And again, anybody who knows me or doesn't know me, hopefully you'll get to know me from this show, Coaching for Health, every Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m. on WWNN Radio. Again, anybody who knows me knows that I am an avid yoga practitioner. I practice Bikram religiously, and it has really saved my emotional and my spiritual and my physical life. But there's an interesting article about the 12 minutes of yoga. And what I think this article may be meant to say, or we can add to it, is that there are 12 very important postures in most of the practices of yoga, maybe not Kundalini, which is energy flow, but certainly in vinyasa practices, ashtanga practices, Bikram yoga, hot yoga, more westernized types of yoga programs and classes. So I believe and I know in my practice of yoga that I certainly can't, 12 minutes is not long enough for me. 12 minutes is better than no minutes, but 12 minutes is not long enough for me. So there are certain postures that are very important. And while they're all important and they all have tremendous health benefits, we talk about warrior postures and tree poses and side angles and locust and hand to feet postures and twisting and spinal twisting and corpse pose, which is what we call dead body pose, which is actually at the end of all yoga practices that I know of. And those are really some of the 12 postures that are very important and not necessarily the 12 minutes. So I encourage all of you again to get into a yoga program, a yoga class. I have practiced many, many forms of yoga, and we ebb and we flow at periods of our life. And so there are, again, many, many forms of yoga, Ashtanga, Kundalini, again, energy flow, Bikram, hot yoga, vinyasa, slow flow. Some of these, again, are westernized, but I encourage, again, everybody to develop a yoga practice and go to a class. I think that classes are extremely nurturing, encouraging, motivating. Community is very, very important in our health and wellness. So build your yoga community and get your cervical and emotional and physical health in tow from yoga. All right, let's talk about peanut butter. So I probably have most of your attention, certainly. Most people I know of, including myself, love peanut butter. I used to eat peanut butter. I used to love peanut butter. 1% of the population, believe it or not, 1% is allergic to peanut butter. Now, most of us know about anaphylactic shock, and a lot of us are allergic to bee stings and nuts and have peanut allergies, but 1% of the population is huge. So it's been a staple of our nutrition and our diets for years and years and years, and most people consume, and this is a staggering statistic, 6 pounds per year, 6 pounds. So that's a lot of peanut butter to consume. Some people consume it, I think, in a day, but that's a lot of peanut butter. It's touted as a healthy fat. It is protein. The recommended daily amount of peanut butter, if you're going to consume peanut butter, is 2 tablespoons per day. It does reduce LDL, which is the bad cholesterol. It can help lower heart disease or heart disease risk. However, I'm not particularly a fan of peanut butter at this stage, and I'll tell you why. One interesting fact about peanut butter is that peanuts are actually legumes. They're not nuts. Now, that's interesting because a lot of people are allergic to peanuts because it's primarily supposed to be a nut allergy. But peanuts are not nuts. Peanuts contain alpha toxins. Peanuts grow underground. And that's something that I don't think that most people know. It's interesting. And because they are grown underground, they acquire molds from the storage of growing underground. They can be carcinogenic. They can affect our immune systems, again, with the allergies. They can cause inflammation. They can cause problems with buildups in our liver and toxicity. The livers really are the toxic parts of our body that regulate toxins and flush out toxins. And peanut butter can build up in our digestive systems over time. So one of the choices that I offer my clients and that I use in my own personal health and wellness is almond butter. I am a huge fan. Almonds grow above ground. They grow on trees. They are mostly, nutritionally wise, certainly more power-packed than peanuts. You get more calories, more nutrients per calorie. They are nutrient-dense. The vitamins and minerals in almond butter contain more power-packed vitamins and nutrients than peanut butter, and I believe it is a great alternative to peanut butter. The health benefits, again, contribute to weight loss, healthy protein, lots of good nutrients, healthy fats, monounsaturated fats, and they're more calorie dense. And most people, not all people, but most people who have allergies to peanuts do not have allergies to almond butter. There are no added sulfites. Almond butter is natural. It's all natural. And again, the benefits are, I think, pretty great. So the next time you go for that jar of peanut butter, maybe incorporate some almond butter, And you'll find that the taste is rich, it's comforting, it's satisfying, it's nutrient dense, and it is very, very healthy. So try that the next time that you are in the butter mood. All right, another interesting hot health topic for this past week is Campbell's Soup Company. Good, right? Campbell's Soup Company. I grew up on Campbell's. I'm sure most of you grew up on Campbell's. They're making big news, certainly, this week. I believe it's this week that it was announced about what they're doing in respect to labeling GMOs. Now, GMO stands for genetically modified organisms. And this is a hot health topic, and we're also on this show going to talk more about GMOs in future shows. But what the Campbell's Soup Company is doing, and they are, I believe, the first major food manufacturer to disclose the GMOs in their ingredients, in their food products. So what's also interesting about what Campbell's Soup is doing is that they are calling for federal labeling standards on all foods that contain GMOs. Now, this is a pretty daunting task, and I have my opinions on GMOs. I'm sure all of you have your opinions on GMOs. I'd be very, very interested to know about your opinions. Let me just give you my email address. If you'd like to email me about your opinions on GMOs, it's susan.bricker coaching4health@outlook.com. Certainly email me about your opinions, about any topics you'd like on the show, any suggestions you have about the show. Please email me. I know it's a long email address, but it is certainly worth it, and I would love to hear from you. This is really opening a proverbial can of soup. To make a pun, and you know I love to be punny, or hope that I'm punny. So GMOs are artificially engineered organisms of some sort. They're obviously not natural. We are in a huge natural way of life in this country. I hope we move more towards a natural way of life. It's interesting that GMOs are so much in the forefront. It's kind of we have a little bit of ambivalence going on between natural and organic and GMOs. But it's a new form of science that can potentially create unstable plant, animal, or viral or bacterial genes. We don't understand the long-term aspects of GMOs. We are developing GMOs certainly to make our products hopefully safer, have a longer shelf life. But that can be not necessarily the case. And so therein lies the conundrum and the controversy about genetically modified organisms. So the real question is, I believe, should we as consumers be informed about the GMOs that are in our products? And if we are, does it make it more helpful to choose the products that we want to buy for our families, that we want to consume? I would think that would be the case. There was a survey done about whether you want to know about whether GMOs are in our products, and there's a staggering 93% of you, 93% really do want to know about GMOs, whether they're in the products you buy, how much are contained in our products. And I think that's really a great thing, and I give a lot of kudos to the Campbell's Soup Company. And there will be more to come on this issue. So where do you stand? Let me know. Email me again, susan.bricker coaching4health@outlook.com, and give me your opinions, ideas on GMOs. We are also on this show going to be doing more shows about labeling and how to read labels, which is extremely, extremely important for our health and wellness. And so that will go into our knowledge about GMOs and how we feel about what's in our products and how we become more consumer educated. So we are going to go to a break. When we come back from our break, we're going to be talking about our topic for today. And I waited till the very end of the show to talk about stress. And boy, did I have it this morning or early this afternoon when I came into the show. Come back. Let's talk about stress. On the flip side, stay with us.
Do you want to be epic? Do you want to be ultra epic? Well, now you can be. With Natural Longevity's Epic Ultra, you can take your health and wellness to a whole new level. Vitamins and minerals are critical to our overall health and well-being, but not just any vitamins and minerals. They are not, and I repeat, not created equal. There are no other products available that contain the same level of all vitamins and trace minerals and other phyto, meaning plants or plant-based nutrients, that Epic Ultra provides. This is absolutely the multivitamin mineral product everyone needs and can take with ease. This potent formula contains over 100 vitamins, minerals, and phytonutrients essential to great health, fortified for your heart, immune system, digestive system, mood, anti-aging, and more. Epic Ultra is a non-negotiable addition to your everyday health routine. So, go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio to see and order this amazing product and to view all the incredible products in the Natural Longevity family. That's adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. And remember the number 4, that's adapt, forhealth.com/WWNN radio. To order now. Do you catch colds too often? Do you suffer from too many sore throats each year? Perhaps your immune system needs a boost. Elijah Insurance Formula from Natural Longevity is a unique supplement that combines therapeutic levels of plant phytochemicals that support your body's immune system and health. This is a unique nutraceutical supplement that is based on groundbreaking research that suggests that extracts of certain plant chemicals have healing effects in the body. These can be greater than the physical benefits from eating the whole plant or the average daily amount of fruits and vegetables consumed in our not-so-great American diet. Elijah Insurance Formula combines therapeutic, antiviral, and antibacterial. Levels derived by plants, powerful antioxidants, digestive enzymes, green tea, vitamins A, C, and E, the mineral selenium, and more to create an extremely potent supplement for health each and every day. There is no other product in the marketplace today that provides some of these ingredients, and no other product comes close to containing all these ingredients at the same therapeutic levels as Elijah Insurance Formula. So give yourself a new insurance policy with Natural Longevity's Elijah Insurance Formula. Go to adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. That's adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. For complete product and ordering information and to view all the incredible products in the Natural Longevity family.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker, your certified resident health coach. All right, so let's talk about stress. Stress. I certainly was a little stressed when I came in early this afternoon. There's a tornado warning, whatever it is. It was pouring, teeming rain, and I really thought I was going to have a bad hair day. I really thought I was going to have a bad hair day. So in the last segment of the show, I want to talk about stress and healthy stress and how you can live a healthy, stressed life. And I know that those of you that are listening, and thank you again for tuning in to this show for health and wellness, Coaching for Health, I know that you probably think I'm a little crazy or maybe a lot crazy. And maybe I am, but I'm going to present to you a way of thinking about stress that I think is truly revolutionary. It certainly is in my life. It certainly has been for my clients. And if you really think about what I'm about to present to you about how to live a healthy, stressful life, it's really going to change how you think about stress and how you go forward. So There is an upside to stress. There really is. And I'm going to talk about the upside in a couple of minutes. But what I want to tell you is we all have stress. I know, you know, we all have stress. It's pretty much, if we think about it, every minute of the day we could have stress. Now, what I want to present to you is a way of thinking about it that can truly change how you perceive your stress. And the optimum word here is perceive. So if we let stress get out of hand, it can kick our proverbial behinds. The word stress is a Latin derivative of stringere, which means to draw tightly. So we know that when we feel stress or we start to get stressed, we start to feel this tightness in our minds, in our bodies, everywhere that you can possibly imagine. It's an adrenaline. It's a physiological, metabolic, emotional response to, and here's the most important thing I want you to remember, a perceived phenomenon as a result of what we think is going to happen physically or emotionally in result to a situation in our lives. It is a perception of what we think may happen as we go through a situation. Now, this is really key because what I want to present to you is our perceptions are very, very powerful. We put our energies into what we think will happen in given situations. And that's something we can't possibly know because we haven't lived it. And one of the things that I tell my clients, one of the most important things in dealing with stress is to be in the present, be in the now. And in the last segment, and the first two segments of the show, I talked about yoga and the importance of yoga. And one of the premises of yoga is to be in the present, be in the now, be in the present moment, because that's all we have, that's all we know, and that's all we can react to. So if I'm perceiving that I had a bad hair day because it was raining, pouring, teeming rain outside, then that's a perception that will cause stress to something that never really happened. And if you begin to think about the fact that stress, most of what we stress about, our perceptions or predispositions to thoughts or responses that we're going to have to situations in our lives that have not happened yet, it can truly transform your life. One of the things that I also want to mention to you about stress, and this is pivotal, this is really pivotal in your life, in my life, in our daily lives, and how we live, how we work, how we parent our families and our elders, and how we go forward in our health and wellness, is that what we really need to do with stress is to understand that living in the now and dealing with what we have to deal with in the present situation is stress release. So that's something that I have learned in my life, and it has really, really helped me move forward. I want you also to know that we have to embrace the fact that stress is in our lives. There's a lot of programs and certainly people that talk about managing stress, eliminating stress, and I happen to feel that we need to embrace it. Stress is a part of our daily lives, and to deny it is to cause suffering. And when we try to handle situations, when we try to manage things, when we try to control things, that causes suffering, and suffering causes stress. If we really understand metabolically and emotionally that we have stress, that's a fact of life, and that it is a part of our lives, and we don't need to get rid of it. We don't need to manage it, because managing also causes a predisposition to try to maneuver it, try to handle it, try to do something else with it. Live every moment, live in the present, and let the information come to you. Conserve your energies into what's really happening at the present moment. And you will come to understand that stress can be healthy. We can have a happy, healthy, stress-filled life if we fill our lives with the ability to understand that we live in the present moment, that we take things as they come, and we conserve our energies and we find solutions to things as they happen. Because if I'm anticipating something that's going to happen tomorrow, something that I think is going to happen 5 minutes from now, that doesn't really happen, then I've caused all these stress hormones and all this metaphysical and metabolic changes to happen that are unhealthy changes in my life and in your life for situations that don't even occur. And if you really think about it, and I want you to really think about it, because hopefully that's what this show will get you to do, is to think about your own health and wellness and what you can do to become really healthy as you move forward in your life. This is critical. So again, embrace it. Understand that we have stress in our lives. Understand that it's a part of our daily lives. We can't get rid of it. We can't control it. We really can't manage it. But we need to understand that it is will come to us, situations will come to us, and how we will deal with the situations will alleviate so much of our stress in our lives. It does affect our overall health. Again, the health disease comes from trying to eliminate stress, trying to manage stress, trying to reduce stress. And I know this is a crazy concept, but the reduction comes in the understanding that it is here. It is here to stay, and it isn't going away. So when we really understand that, again, we will really help our own personal health and wellness. So think about that after the show. Think about that as you go through your day. Think about that as you go through all the days and help your families and your children with understanding that it's here and it's here to stay. I also want to give you a few tips on what to do in respect to stress, how to get your energy in understanding, how to live a stress-filled, healthy life. When we regard stress as a daily part of our lives, it can help strengthen our immune system. We do get a fight-or-flight response that helps our brain power. There's been interesting studies about breast cancer that understanding that stress is in our lives and surrendering to stress can help the suppression of estrogen in respect to breast cancer and estrogen receptive cancers. It can also be beneficial in fighting Alzheimer's. It keeps the brain functioning at a higher level. It helps us when we embrace our stress to multitask. It aids in our decision making. And again, the most important thing I can tell you, and I'm going to be repetitive in this, is to embrace your stress, be like the yogis, stay present, use your energy for what's on your proverbial plate at this very second. Let the information come to you when it comes to perceiving what stress is happening, and be patient. Also, keeping a journal can be very, very important. Writing things down, what we see we can change. What we see becomes crystallized. What we see becomes dimensional, and we can change what we see. And then when we look at our journals and we see some of the things that we write down, we just say to ourselves, well, how could that have happened? How could that be? All right, I have come to the end of another Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker. It's time to end our hour together. I look forward to seeing you next Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m. WWNN Radio. Next week, I'm going to talk about what am I doing wrong? That's going to be the question of the hour. Plus hot health topics for the week. Again, until then, remember, it's all for the health of it. Be well. See ya on the other end. Take care.
You've been listening to Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker. To connect with Suzy, call 248-762-4961 or send her an email to susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. And to find out about your free health consultation, discounts, special programs, and products, go to her website, coachingforhealth.net. Again, call Suzy at 248-762-4961. And tune in again next time for more Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker.